morning, friends. It's good to see you this morning. And I just had a few encouraging words for you as you start your day. A while back, a book came out by the title, Not a Fan, and the author's name was Kyle Eidelman. In the book, the premise of the book was an analogy between those who are followers of Jesus and the difference between a follower and a fan versus what it looks like on a ball field where you have a whole stadium full of fans and only a few that are actually in the game. Well, I think he made a very good analogy, and I think that sometimes we find ourselves more of fans of Jesus rather than followers. We want to say, encourage others, go get them, you can do it, good job. But to actually sit at the feet of Jesus, to be excited about spending time with him, that is something that's important for those who call themselves Christians. It's important to follow him, to take his words and let them impact our hearts. And that's why we appreciate his word so much. God's given us his word. And I want to bring to you a word from God's word really briefly this morning, found in Romans chapter 6. And this is what it says. What shall we say then? Shall we continue in sin that grace may abound? Certainly not. How shall we who died to sin live any longer in it? Or do you not know that as many of us as were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we were buried with him through baptism into death, that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in newness of life. I tell you what, that comes from one who wasn't really necessarily a fan of Jesus, Paul the Apostle, who persecuted Christians at one time, did not like Jesus. But one day he had an experience, an encounter with Jesus that changed his life forever. And I believe that is what those who follow Jesus desire, an encounter with him that will continue to change their lives forever. Yesterday, I was on a conference call with our district superintendent, and he said it very well, and I want to quote him. He said this. He says, our Christianity is not about sinning less, but about being obedient more. You see, that is what comes from someone who follows Jesus. Let's learn to always remember that Jesus is present in our lives. Let's pray. Lord Jesus, thank you so much for the time that you took to spend with us on this earth and the time that you still continue to spend teaching us from your word and drawing us close to you. We are so thankful that you are the one that makes all the difference in our lives. And we do pray for those who don't know you, that they will have an encounter with you that will change their life forever. So Lord, draw us closer to you today. We lift up this day before you, and we give it to you. In your name, in Jesus' name, amen.